everyone, welcome to my channel. And in my today's tutorial, I will tell you how to use nested if statement in programming. Okay, so let's start the video. So for this, you need to know what is nested if statement. So this is used to specify multiple conditions without repeating if statement again and again. So basically, whenever we want to check multiple conditions, there we will use this nested if else. So how to write that? This is a if statement under another if or else statement. So nesting means one under another. So we will write if statement under another if or else statement. That is why it is also called if else ladder. Okay, let me show you the syntax of this if else ladder. So for that, first we will write our if statement, and within bracket we will provide the condition. If the condition is true, then it will execute this statement part. If it is false, then it will go to the else part of this if statement. So now we will write the else part. So here we are writing the else part. Now in some scenarios, we need to check more than one condition. So there we will write if with this else. So here we will write else space if, and then within bracket, same way we will provide the condition here. If this condition is satisfied, then only this statement will be executed. If not, if this condition is false, then we have to write the else part of this else if also. So here we are writing the else part and the statement to be executed. Okay, so here by the color you can understand this else part is under this if statement. If this condition is not satisfied, then it will go to this else statement, and after that it will check this condition. If this condition is satisfied, then it will execute this statement. If the condition is false, then it will go to this else part, okay, and execute this statement. Okay, so if this condition is false, then only it will go to this part. Okay, and if this condition is false, then only it will go to this part. If this condition is true, then it will not execute this else if and this else part. Okay, so let me show you with one example how it works. So for that, we have one program here to accept a number and check whether it is a negative number or positive number or a zero. Okay, so basically, we will enter a number and we will check it is a negative number or a positive number or it is a zero. Okay, so for that, as usual, we will import java.util.asterisk package, because we will use scanner class to take input. Okay, then we are declaring our class public class test. Then inside the class, we are writing our main method, that is public static void main string args. Now within the main method, we are creating the scanner class object here by writing scanner space sc equals to new space scanner system.in. So sc is the scanner class object. After that, we are writing one statement system.out.println, enter the number for checking. So now we will input the number. Okay, for that we are using the variable a, which is integer type. So we are writing int space a equals to sc.nexting. Here sc is the scanner class object which we have declared here, and next int is the scanner class integer type method. Okay, integer method of the scanner class to input integer values. Okay, and here whatever value we will enter will be stored within a. So the number for checking is stored within a. Now we will check it is a negative number, positive number or a zero. So for that, we are writing the condition if a greater than 0. Okay, so if a number is greater than 0, then of course it is a positive number. So we are writing if a greater than 0 system.out.println, it is a positive number, then printing the value. Okay, if the condition is not satisfied, then it will go to the else part of this if. And within the else part, we are writing another if. So we are writing else space if a less than 0. So if a is not greater than 0, then we should go for the checking it is less than 0 or not. So we are checking here a less than 0. If yes, then it will go here, it will print the statement system.out.println, it is a negative number, and printing the value. If this condition is not satisfied and this is also not satisfied, then it will go to the else part of this if, and it will print system.out.println neither a positive number nor a negative number, it is a zero, and printing the value. Okay, then end of the main method, end of the class. So this is how we can enter one number and check it is a negative number or positive number or a zero. Okay, so let me show you the output. Before that, we need to compile it. So I'm compiling the program, class compiled, no syntax error. I am minimizing the window, then right click, click on void main, click OK. Here you can see enter the number for checking. So I am entering a positive number like 5, enter. So it is a positive number 5. Okay, now let me show you the same program for negative number checking. So the last output was for the positive number. Now I am entering a negative number. Here it is showing enter the number for checking. So I am entering minus 5. Press enter. You can see the output. It is a negative number minus 5. Now let me show you the output for 0 also. So here again it is showing enter the number for checking. So I am entering 0. Enter. Neither a positive number nor a negative number, it is a zero. Okay, so you can see for all the numbers the answer is shown here. Okay, so one program I have written for all the number checking, positive, negative and zero. Okay, so thank you class, like and share the video, click on the photo to subscribe. Thank you.